Created by Leonard Freeman, Hawaii Five-0 was an American procedural drama that followed the lives of a handful of state police force officials, guided by a former U.S. Naval officer, Steve McGarrett. The camera raced with them as they chased criminals, organized crime syndicates, and international secret agents through exotic locations such as Honolulu, island of Oahu, Los Angeles, Singapore, and Hong Kong. Not many people know this, but the idea of the show was actually inspired by a special police task force that existed under martial law after World War II. Hawaii Five-0 gave us many memorable catchphrases and slang terms, as well as a classic theme song that Americans absolutely loved. However, over and above everything, the series filled our screens with absorbing mysteries and mind-blowing action. At the time of the airing of its last episode, Hawaii Five-0 was the longest-running police drama in American TV history. In this video, we're going to share 10 facts that most fans don't know about this legendary series. Make sure you stick around until the end of the video to find out which episode of Hawaii Five-0 was banned forever and still can't be viewed anywhere. Factsverse presents the banned episode of Hawaii Five-0 and 9 other facts. If you're a longtime fan of the series, let us know by clicking the like button. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel and click the notification bell to stay up to date with our newest videos. Jack Lord was not the original choice for the role of Steve McGarrett. Jack Lord was the perfect Steve McGarrett in many ways. He projected toughness and seemed like the guy you could trust to guide a state police criminal investigation department. In real life, Jack Lord paid extreme attention to details and often fought with network executives to ensure that the team was getting full freedom to create and present the content they liked and wanted. Thus, Lord is often seen to have played a key role in the success of Hawaii Five-0, and will never be forgotten as the tough and daring Steve McGarrett that Americans so admired. However, not many people know that the role of McGarrett was offered to several other actors before it was given to Jack Lord. Among others, the part was offered to Richard Boone of the Have Gun, Will Travel fame, and Robert Brown, who played Lazarus in the Star Trek episode titled The Alternative Factor. The role was also offered to the Hollywood superstar Gregory Peck. However, it ultimately landed in Lord's Kitty and made him instantly famous. Jack Lord also had something in common with his character Steve McGarrett. They both served in the military. The slang term 5-0 for the police came from this show. The creators of the show were at one point in a fix about what name should be given to the show. Several ideas were put on the table. However, since most of the show was shot in Hawaii, the makers decided to pay tribute to the state through their show's title. They decided to call the series Hawaii 5-0, because Hawaii was the 50th state that came into existence in 1959. Thus, Hawaii 5-0 was chosen to be the name of the show, as well as the fictional police division that the show follows. As the popularity of the show grew, the term 5-0 became a slang term for the police. When the first episode of Hawaii 5-0 was aired on September 20, 1968, Hawaii had only been a state for 9 years. Reza Badii, the godfather of American television, created the opening credits sequence. Reza Badii was an Iranian-American film director and a known name in Hollywood. Badii came to the United States to pursue a degree in film studies at the prestigious Syracuse University and later directed several popular television series. Such was his mastery over his craft that Badii was given the title of the Godfather of American Television and was honored by the Directors Guild of America for directing the maximum number of hours on American television. Other than directing several TV shows, Reza is often also credited with creating stunning intros, such as the intro to the Mary Tyler Moore Show. Reza also created the opening credits sequence for Hawaii 5-0, which began with the crashing of waves and zoomed through various beautiful locations. The opening credits sequence was as memorable as it was scenic. Many consider the Hawaii Five-0 theme song to be one of the best television themes of all time. The Hawaii Five-0 theme song is an instrumental piece created by Morton Stevens, which won him 2 Emmy Awards, one in 1970 and the other in 1974. The show's theme song is often considered to be one of the best themes of all time, and many believe that the Hawaii Five-0 theme song played a crucial role in adding to the overall excitement of the show. Thus, when the 2010 reboot version of Hawaii Five-0 used a synthesizer and guitar-based version of the original theme, the negative reviews it garnered compelled the makers to switch back to the original song. Not many people know that The Ventures covered the Hawaii Five-0 theme song and made it reach the number 4 spot on the 1968 Billboard Hot 100. Hawaii Five-0's theme has been used time and again in popular culture as well. It was featured in the film 50 First Dates and most recently in the 2019 Papa John Pizza commercial.
Say aloha to Papa John's Super Hawaiian Pizza.
It has also become the unofficial fight song of the University of Hawaii. The song also gained immense popularity in the UK and was played quite often on the dance floors during the 70s. Donald Tai Loi Ho, popularly known as Don Ho, the famous American traditional pop singer, gave the theme song some beautiful lyrics and recorded his version, which also became quite famous.
If you're feeling lonely, you can come with me.
All in all, it's safe to say that the Hawaii Five-O theme song is a musical piece that TV audiences will never forget. The cast referred to their first set as the Mongoose Mansion. The show was mostly shot in Hawaii. However, back in the 60s, Hawaii lacked the presence of the movie industry. Thus, shooting in the state was a challenging task, with the crew often reaching out to inexperienced locals who came with no prior experience and learned their jobs on set, which made shooting sequences difficult. The first season of the show was shot in Quonset huts, lightweight and semicircular structures made from corrugated galvanized steel and immensely popular during World War II. However, shooting in these huts wasn't easy as the roofs continually leaked and the rats were present in abundance. For this reason, the cast began calling these huts the Mongoose Mansions. After the first season became a hit, the cast and crew moved to Fort Ruger, and the final four seasons were shot at Diamond Head. Before we move on to our next interesting fact, please click the bell button and we promise to keep you entertained with our upcoming videos. The opening credits of the show feature the famous Ilikai Hotel. The opening credits begin with waves crashing against the beach, and then the camera races through various beautiful locations in Hawaii, eventually landing at the famous Ilikai Hotel and luxury suites, where Jack Lord is shown standing on the balcony of a penthouse suite. Ilikai Hotel and Luxury Suites is a luxury resort located on the Wakai Beach in Honolulu, and it's possible to book the exact same suite where Jack Lord was shown standing in the starting sequence of Hawaii Five-O, and have your own Jack Lord moment. Other than Hawaii, the show also showcased several different beautiful locations in countries such as Hong Kong and Singapore. One of the scenes in the opening credits shows a woman dancing and moving her belly in a Honolulu bar. This woman, Helen Kuoho Torko, earned $150 for her dancing sequence and went on to become a professor of business technology at the Windward Community College in Honolulu. The actor who played Chin Ho Kelly was a police officer in real life. Cam Fong, the actor who played the role of Chin Ho Kelly, was a police officer in real life. Cam was born in Kalihi neighborhood of Honolulu and started his career as a boilermaker at Pearl Harbor. He witnessed the Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor in 1941. In 1944, after the death of his wife and two children, Cam Fong decided to join the Honolulu Police Department, where he worked for 16 years. After his retirement, he joined community theater. Cam Fong had actually auditioned for the role of the lead villain, Wo Fat. However, his almost two-decade experience with the Honolulu Police Department made him the perfect choice for the role of Chin Ho Kelly. Cam Fong Chun's son, Dennis Chun, also became an actor and managed to grab roles in both Hawaii Five-O as well as its successor show, Magnum P.I. Wo Fat got his name from a Chinese restaurant. Wo Fat, the nemesis of Steve McGarrett and Hawaii Five-O's lead villain, appeared for a total of 11 times in the entire series. However, not many people know that Leonard Freeman, the creator of the show, took the name Wo Fat from a Chinese restaurant in the Chinatown area of Honolulu. The building is registered on the National Register of Historic Places and was sold for a whopping $4 million in 2017. Magnum PI was created to make use of Hawaii Five-O sets. Hawaii Five-O went off air in 1980, leaving the American audiences wanting more. The studio understood this audience sentiment. More importantly, they had to do something with the production facilities they had built at Diamond Head for Hawaii Five-O. They therefore decided to start another show in Hawaii, and this idea was the beginning of Magnum PI, an American crime drama revolving around a private investigator, played by Tom Selleck, and his life in Oahu, Hawaii. The show often made direct references to Steve McGarrett of Hawaii Five-O. As a matter of fact, in episode 6 of the series, Magnum introduces himself as McGarrett of Five-O. Not many people know this, but the role of Thomas Sullivan Magnum III was first offered to Jack Lord, who repeatedly turned down the offer, sending it in Tom Selleck's lap. Though Magnum PI did well and consistently ranked in the top 20 during the first 5 years of its run, it wasn't as successful as its predecessor, Hawaii Five-O. One episode was banned and will never be shown again. The episode, Bored, She Hung Herself, aired on January 7, 1970. In this episode, the Five-O were shown investigating the death of a yoga student named Wanda, played by Pamela Murphy, who lost her life while trying to perform a complicated yoga technique. Don Quine, the American actor who played Stacey Granger on The Virginian, played the role of Wanda's boyfriend and was shown as the prime suspect. This was a rather different episode as the American audience was not used to seeing people attempting such forms of yoga for fun. After the show ended, an American viewer tried the same yoga technique as shown in the episode Bored She Hung Herself and died. After this, the episode was barred from airing in syndication. The episode is also missing from the complete DVD set of the series. It's also not available for online streaming and downloading. In 1980, when Hawaii Five-0 went off the air, it was the longest-running police drama on American television. During its 12-year-long run, the show won many awards and, more importantly, an abundance of love from its audience. For years, this elite task force constantly going after big criminals and undercover secret agents had American audiences hooked to their television sets. Though the show went off the air in 1980, its memorable characters, unforgettable catchphrases and slang, and iconic theme song continue to inspire the pop culture to this day, and will continue to do so in the years to come. So, did you already know these interesting facts about Hawaii Five-0? Or is there anything you know and we've missed out on? If yes, please let us know through the comments section. And don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel to allow us to entertain you with more such interesting content.